What does it look like? What does the simple past look like? Let's
save the ED.
You just add ED, right? So I'm going to use an example, and all I want you to do again is to remind me how I can use this simple past with affirmative, negative, and questions, okay? So here's an example. Jonathan lived in Egypt when? How long ago? How many years ago? 2 years ago? 3 years ago? Okay. 3 years ago, okay? Jonathan lived, simple past. Jonathan lived in Egypt 3 years ago, okay? So how do you make this affirmative statement, make it negative first?
Didn't.
Wait, why are we using didn't and not doesn't?
It's the past,
right? Okay, so didn't live in Egypt 3 years ago. Okay, good. How do I make a yes, no question? Good. Did he live in Egypt 3 years ago? Okay. How about a yes, not a yes, no, a WH question?
Why did Jonathan live in Egypt?
Perfect. Okay. Were you able to do this as we were doing it? Make sure you know that you need to use, what's this called?
Did.
What kind of verb is it?
This
is a helping verb. Yes, this is a helping verb. Make sure you have a helping verb with the main verb for questions, right? And also for when you want to make negatives, okay? Always, right? Now, that's what it looks like. That's a simple past. That's a regular verb, right? That's a regular verb. We talked about irregular verbs last week. But, okay, so this is what it looks like. That's the easy part, right? But I'm going to erase it. Don't worry. You guys can see this in your book. But now I want to know when. When do we use this? Does anyone know? There's a few
something
different.
Finish actions.
Good. So finished actions, right? Is that example a finished action? Jonathan lived in Egypt 3 years ago?
Yeah.
It's finished, right? Okay. We also use this is the main time we use the simple past, when something's done. But you also should focus on the time, right? So we use it for finished time periods, okay? So for example, some finished time periods are like last year. That's finished, right? What's some more examples of a finished time period?
Last week. Last night. Yesterday.
Good. How about in, like with the year, 1990? Is that past?
Yeah.
Is it finished?
Yes.
What if I said...
Once upon a time.
Good. Once upon a time. That's how you can start a story. Good. These are all finished time periods. So usually when you're going to say or write a finished time period, then you're also going to use the simple past, right? Okay. So. She read a book last night, simple past. Why are we using simple past?
Last night.
Because it's a finished time and it's also finished action. The action is over, right? Okay. Now, when we're using the simple past, we're usually focusing on one thing. Not always, but usually when somebody wants to know when something happened, they're usually, and you're talking about the past, they usually want you to use simple past because they're referring to a finished time in the past. So when you get this question, when, think, okay, probably, I should probably use simple past, okay? When did you move to the United States? I moved here two years ago. When did you start Pierce College?
Last year.
So you're focusing on finished times and finished actions when you hear this question. Not always, but usually, okay? Oh, I forgot one thing. Ago. This is really important when you see the word ago, right? How do we use that?
3 days ago.
Yeah. So it has to be a duration, right? Like 3 days
ago,
right? 1 day ago, 5 years ago, right? Okay. Whenever you hear ago, you always use simple past, okay?